Hi, everybody. It's patch 6.1 day, and I'm back with another video about my Let's Play through Endwalker's story. So, you may notice that these next few videos are going to be a bit out of order, because I haven't finished uploading 6.0 base game, and now I'm doing 6.1, so it'll be a little bit out of order, but I will make a separate playlist to put the 6.1 videos in for the time being until I finish uploading everything in 6.0, and then I'll merge the playlist. But enough of me talking, you're not here for that, so let's get into the story. Oh, this is so... Tataru! Newfound adventure, Tataru is putting on a pot of tea and looks in need of company. Of course! Avery, how lovely it is to see you. If you're not in too much of a rush, I was about to make a pot of tea. Would you like a cup? Yeah. Of course. Take a seat then, and I'll find us something to nibble on as well. Yeah! Hell yeah! Sorry if you heard that. Look at all those tasty desserts. No, it's so quiet now without the scions.
It's so much quieter these days without everyone around.
Yeah, like what I just said, Tataru. Yo, you're reading my mind.
Not that I'm pining for your return, you understand. I have my sources, and I know that each and every one of you is doing well and keeping busy with your endeavors. Meanwhile, I'm left with a surplus of free time and the question of how to make the most of it. What about you? Any plans for the immediate future?
No, not really. Savage rating. Oh! Yeah, no, yeah, a grand new adventure, of course. Or I'm still mulling it over? No, a grand new adventure, of course.
Traveling to the edge of existence and back wasn't enough? Well, if that's the case, I might have a suggestion for you.
Okay, listen, Tataru, that whole journey was not... Okay, it was an adventure, but it wasn't a good adventure. I want a nice, peaceful adventure.
You fought bravely and selflessly, helping those in need and saving our star from unimaginable threats. For your deeds, you've been hailed as the champion of Eorzea and a host of other incredible things. But why not put those titles aside for a while?
Oh? What are you saying, Tataru?
Acquit yourself as a simple adventurer again, and travel the world in search of wonder.
Yeah! Back to our roots! You're right, who knows what mysteries are still waiting to be discovered? That's a great idea, but where to start? That's a great idea, but where do we start? Where do we go to first?
Oh, with so many exciting places to choose from, it's hard to narrow it down. But I believe I have the perfect destination in mind.
Tataru is like always like four steps ahead of us in everything, and it scares me, but also it's like, hell yeah. At least you have your life together.
Thavnir, that's where you should go next.
Huh? Thavnir? I'm sorry, what's
Thavnir? I doubt you were able to squeeze in a proper tour of Ra'zat-Harn the last time you were there. What with the burning skies and rampaging monsters and so forth. And I'm sure Vritra would be pleased to see you.
Oh yeah. Oh, I miss Vritra. He was cool.
Then there's the bounty itself. The Empire's presence in the region was always a deterrent to exploration. So if you've a mind to sail that sea, now's your chance. Just think of all the new experiences you could have.
Tell me, have you been to the ruins beneath the waters of the Bounty?
I hold a gun. Stop. Stop it.
As the bearer of Azem's crystal, you may consider your duty to see at least that much.
They really said, you ain't done. You ain't done with Emmett yet. But yeah, no, like, it's interesting. The ruins beneath the Bounty. Like, what is, you know, like,
Oh, I know that look. That's an adventurer ready to take on the world.
No!
In anticipation of an occasion like this, I was planning to gift you a new set of traveling clothes, but it's, still a work in progress.
No, don't worry about it. Take your time. I'm so sorry. That's my free company.
Shouldn't take much longer now, though, so sit tight and I'll have the last few bits sewn up before you can finish another cup of tea.
Joke's on you, Chugs a cup of tea. Make sure it has pockets. You're the best, Taru. You're the best. Oh, she's sewing. Oh, look at her.
Stitch in here and trim in there. Knot the threads with love and care. Just a little more to go. I'm sure you're still brimming with excitement. I'm one with the needle. See how the fabric surrenders to my whims.
Oh, Don't worry. Fell asleep.
I'll make sure the lining has plenty of pockets for all your little treasures. I swear adventurers are worse than children when it comes to hoarding every feather and leaf and animal hide they come across.
Don't call us out. Don't call the crafters out. Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh my god.
Oh, we mustn't forget the waterproofing. Gods forbid you forget to disrobe before plunging into the sea, or a river, or a piping hot bath.
Are we just gonna fall asleep? Whoa! Hello? Hey, I thought we were done with the cryptic dreams. Okay. What is this? Wait. Isn't that? No, huh? That's...
Unless I am returned.
Xenos is void set, right? You can't just show that and then go, newfound adventure. Huh? Hey, Yoshibi, I wanted a nice, happy, like, cute slice of life expansion. Oh, shoot. Oh. Hi, Taru!
Ah, you're awake.
Sorry, I fell asleep.
My apologies. I do get a little carried away with my sewing. You seem awfully cheerful. Pleasant dream? Or are you just looking forward to the next chapter of your grand saga?
Yeah, pleasant dream. I wouldn't call that pleasant at all.
Either way, I promise to provide you with new apparel, and so I shall. If you'll accompany me to the Diamond Forge, we can put the finishing touches on your outfit, shall we?
They put away my weapon for this cutscene, and I'm honestly so thankful they did. My weapon is so bright. It's so fucking bright, like ridiculously so. Oh, I should probably do that. There we go. Look at this shit, dude. Alright. Where are we going? Oh, like right outside. Okay, never mind. I was about to teleport. Now we're going right outside. Okay. God, it feels so good to be playing a story again. Oh yeah, you know what? No. I forgot that I could fly in this area. It's been a while. It's been a while. Observe as the artiste refines her piece into a masterpiece. And no napping this time. I only need a moment. You'll see. A little more room on the shoulders. Open up the cuffs. A final adjustment to the hem. Oh, are they gonna show us in the new outfit? All done. Let's see how it looks on the mannequin. Oh. Oh, look at it! Well, what do you think? Doesn't it just scream ready for a bold new adventure? Oh, that's so cute. I'm so glad you approve. You've outdone yourself, Tataru. Thank you. Or, so what do I owe you? Yeah, nah. You've outdone yourself. Oh, stop. You'll make me blush. If you really want to thank me, though, all I ask is that you wear this on your travels. Oh, I'm so sorry. I can't do that. See, this chest piece that I'm wearing, Savage rating, and I used Jetlock on it. So I'm not glamming over it anytime soon. Or at least anywhere lots of adventurers might gather. They'll look at you, a famous hero, and wonder, wherever did he purchase those stylish yet practical garments? And before you know it, hordes of new customers will be climbing over each other, ready to place orders at Tataru Taru's boutique. I will make sure to advertise for you. I can hear it now, the merry clink clink of gil overflowing from my coffers, sweet music to my ears. Oh, look at- Hold on, I need to try these on. Oh, that looks so cute. Hold on, I want to see how this looks with jet black. That looks honestly not bad. I don't think it fits the outfit though, because I don't know, it doesn't fit. I mean, I might. Who knows? Okay, let's try on the full outfit. After me. Oh, that looks so cute. Oh my god. Hold on, full outfit. Wait. Oh, we get earrings and a necklace? Wait. Wait, we've never gotten like a necklace and earring like set to match. We've never had that before. Oh, look at that. Are there no pants? There are no pants. Anyways. Oh, that's so cute. Okay. Burgeoning Merchant Empire Society, you must be excited to start a fresh chapter of your life. New places to go, new people to meet. I often wonder how you remember all your experiences and exploits without taking at least a few notes. I do. I have a nice little journal. Oh, maybe you should start doing that. You'll never know when some odd past detail might become relevant. Or if one day you'll take a blow to the head and forget the better part of the past decade. Something to keep in mind, in any case. I hope I don't get- Oh! Collection expanded, the Unending Codex. Oh! That is so cool. It's now available. New entries, prominent terms, and characters will be added to the Codex as you progress to the MSQ. Nice! That's really neat, actually. Oh god, that's a lot more people. Alright. bountiful ruins. Totoro has some advice to share with you. As the former receptionist and sometimes intelligence gatherer of these lions, allow me to offer you a word of advice. Do not expect juicy rumors to simply fall into your lap. Adventurers rely on gossip, and the best place to pick up information are taverns and markets. At present, you only have a broad destination in mind. When you arrive in Thavnir, I suggest you explore your options at Merid's Mayhen, the finest drinking establishment in Rodzaman. Charm the people, or employees, and they'll not only point you in the direction of the local tellers, but also share with you tricks for loosening their tongues. That is it. Okay. Now I really must be getting back to running my boutique. Enjoy the journey, Avery, and may fair fortune find you. Are we getting one, I think? Maybe. Alright, once on we go. Plus Reaper Dash, for making it so that I can just dash. Welcome to Merid's Mayhen. Oh, hello, I did not recognize you at first. Are you here alone? Let me find you a table. Ruins beneath the bounty. Would you be speaking of the sunken treasure vault? We have one regular, a historian in fact, who could tell you all about it. There he is, Professor Jolene. I thought I saw him come in. Although a somewhat private sort, the professor is quick to befriend those who share his fondness for the Mayhen's unique beverages. Offer him any drink from our selection, and he should happily share everything he knows about the vault you seek, and a few other odd bits besides. Whatever you buy for him is on the house, by the way. If Merid found out I took coin from Thavnir's savior, she would have me scrubbing pots for a week. Hey, I'm more than happy to, like, pay. I don't have 3 mil again. Huh? Oh, okay. I was wondering why there was a group over there. I was like, huh? Alright, yes? Oh no! The following event cannot be skipped. You may wish to cancel any pending Duty Finder registration. Okay, sure. And what may I do for you, my Eorzean friend? I want to ask you about the sunken vault and the bounty, just a friendly chat. How about a drink? Yeah, how about a drink? What would you like? Well, I certainly wouldn't say no to a drink freely offered. Here we are, one of Merid's finest. Enjoy. Ah, lovely. Bottoms up. Jolene empties the cup in a single pull. That was very kind of you, sir, but I know when I'm being softened up. What is it that you want from me? Oh-ho! Chasing down that old tale, are you? It does seem to appeal to the adventurous at heart. Now, where to begin? Might I assume you've heard of Alzada? He was Khan of the Auri tribe, which sailed to Thavnir from the mainland, and a key figure in the history of Rodzaman. I do not know. His decision to aid the Arcasadra is what ultimately won them the war against the Gajdasura, thus allowing our predecessors to lay the foundation for this thriving city-state. The truly fascinating stories, however, concern his grandson, Alzadal III, who was known for his deeds as satrap in Razathan's earlier days. Some attest that this man traveled to another world entirely and returned with glittering riches, others that he brokered an alliance with a certain worm of the first brood. Then there is the tale of the sunken vault, the one you seem most curious about. According to this legend, Alzadal III claimed a small island somewhere in the middle of the bounty. There he built a structure reaching clear to the bottom of the sea, a deep and secret storehouse, and locked all his worldly wealth within. In the centuries since, whenever a natural disaster or hardship befell Razathan, folk would remember the tale of hidden treasure. Hardy souls would set out to claim their fortune, but precious few ever made it home. Oh wait, that reminds me of, what was it? Amarant. Where there was that structure that not Geralt built that went all the way to the bottom. Would you like to hear more? Apologies, I have a slight tickle in my... Oh, my cup appears to be empty. Oh. Uh-huh. Malil, another round for the professor. We can play this game. Ah, I see we've reached an understanding. You're a sharp one, adventurer. Another for the professor. No, today was a splendid day to visit the man. He's gonna get drunk before he can tell us, so. And it's gonna be like, oh, you failed, and it's like, god damn it, okay. Galeen gulps down his newest drink with gusto. There he is. Where were we? Ah, yes. Those who did return from seeking the treasure vault flatly refused to speak of what they saw. Did this discourage others? Nay, quite the opposite. Such accounts only serve to feed the legend, and the golden lure grew stronger than before. That reminds me of something Azuma was saying. Azuma's a fellow connoisseur of spirituous potables. Yes, he is. Anyway, he was saying that one of his acquaintances went after the treasure himself. Hasn't been seen since he set sail, I hear. But he did have... I can say no more. You seem a generous sort. What kind of man would I be to encourage what is clearly a foolhardy quest? If my words sent you to your death, I could never live with myself. I am no stranger to peril. I'll be fine. Just tell me. Is that so? Perhaps it's your turn to tell a tale then. What manner of dangers have you faced? Where do I start? The very edge of existence. From anyone else, I'd struggle to believe it. But I recognize you now. You're the hero of the final days. Drink. I need another drink to settle my nerves. Malil, more of the same, if you please. As you wish, but this one is on your coin, Professor. Jaleen drains yet another cup dry. Oh, he is gone. Anyway, you being who you are, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to share a little more. This friend of Azuma's, he was desperate to buy the treasure map, one which showed the way to the entrance of the vault. Seems he could only get it from some merchant. What's his name? Bah, I forget. Let's drink a toast to you, my new best friend. Malil, more drinks. Oh no. Signal for water instead. Get him water. The wink! Your drink, sir. Ah, marvelous. I'm parched. He's not gonna know the difference. He's not. He gulps on the water. Oh, that was water. Did you tell her to bring me water? Still, that's probably for the best. You're very kind of you, really. My head will certainly thank you in the morning. I seem to have overindulged. I am put in the mind of the world's, in the words of Master Jolzan, be wary how much you drink. What? Be wary how much of the drink you swallow, lest it swallow you. Forgive me, I will subject you to no more of these unseemly and unseemly antics. If you want to speak with Azuma, as I said, we share a taste for the Mayhem's fine spirits. You probably came in here as we were talking. I wish you fortune in finding your fortune. You have appeared to learn all that Jolene has to share regarding the Undersea Vault. To find out more, you will need to locate a man by the name of Azuma. Aww. Okay. He's over here, isn't he? That's where the group of people are. I'm gonna end this episode here, though, because it's 25 minutes. That wasn't a lot at all, but, you know. I'm going by time, not content. So, I will see you all in the next episode. So, until then, take care, be safe.